technology that at LensMint that happened over the past 1 month. I invite my colleague, Mrs. Tiju, to handle the session.
Thanks, Aria. Hi, myself Tiju, working as a software engineer here at FAYA. Let's start the tech quiz. Facebook FAYA Developer Conference. Facebook Developer Conference FAYA is going on now. It's today's conference. Let's see some of the major announcements that happened on the first day. First one is clear display. Facebook announces a privacy tool called clear display. It's something like deleting our cache or browsing history in our web browser. Clear history, Facebook giving the user the power to manage his local data stored in Facebook. Next one is Zuckerberg announces that they are going to implement a dating feature called Face Date. Using this, the member can browse for the potential members and can start chatting using this app. Actually, it's an end-to-end chatting app. Next one is video chat. Facebook announces that they are introducing a video chat in their Instagram app. Also, they are introducing this in their WhatsApp group. Next one is on hardware. In Facebook's virtual reality headset, they are introducing the Oculus Go, and they can use it without connecting to our computer or smartphones. Next is Windows 10 updates. We all have had experience of reading into emails and files that we have in our computer and unable to locate. Using Windows timeline, it allows users to find out contents in our computer by searching through text. Let's see a quick video. Next one is nearby sharing. This is something similar to Apple's AirDrop that the user can share videos or files to nearby devices using Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. Next one is focus on. This will help users to reduce distractions while walking by disabling unwanted notifications from other platforms like social media. We can set a time frame so that we want to after that time frame, give a summary of the at the same time, we can explore some important messages using that. Angular conference happened last week. It has some exciting features. I know some exciting Google is smart speakers, Google Home in India. Actually, it has two variations, Google Home and Google Home Mini. And it's now available through Flipkart. And Google Home is priced $10,000 and Google Home Mini is $4,500. And Google is an exciting app called Ghost Grasshopper. Actually, it's a it's help users to actually beginners to the study development, and it's developed by Google Google group called Area Continuum. Okay, that's all from my side.
Thank you, Vishnu. Now, without much fuss, let's move on to the main session of the day. Mr. Anand Ramkumar, lead engineer of experience technologies, will lead the delay of the month on device selection strategy and verticals of testing and is passionate about programming, performance testing, creating automation framework and setting up a test environment. I invite Mr. Anand Ramkumar to take the session.
Thank you, thank you. Sir, thanks for joining us. Okay, my name is Anand Ramkumar. I have worked for experience on technology in the testing department. And today I'm going to talk about device selection strategy and automated testing for coming from the AWS Device Farm. And we'll close the session with continuous integration and testing, taking Jenkins as an example. Now, this is the definition. So what does mobile application compatibility? Simple terms, it is whether my application is going to work on this operating system, different operating system, different hardware, and in the network, different network environment. Simple. Now, what is the variability in the market which is the cause of this fragmentation? Let's see that. Now, this is December 2017. You see that this much is Android. This much is iOS. So, if you're coming out with an app, you have to think that 73% will be using Android. Right? Now, iOS is 19%. Equally strong, I'm not telling you it's equally strong, but it has got a chance. So, this is one level, that operating system. One is Android, one is iOS. Now, think about next level, OS version. Android, 25% is still using Lollipop. Marshmallow and Nugget. Only 1% is using the latest one, which was released in August 17th. But in the iOS side, September 17th it was released, 65% have already upgraded to latest version. So we have an OS, multiple OS on top of it, versions now. Correct? Now, this is a mobile vendor. Samsung is this much, I got Apple this much. So this is another level. You got Lenovo, Motorola, whatever it is. Like they all have some chunks. Right? Now, OS level, OS versions, now you got manufacturer level also. Now you'll be thinking whether, okay, my OS version, my IDE is going to support all these backward integration or backward compatibility or forward compatibility. My IDE will support this screen resolution problem. Lot of problems are taken care of by the IDE. Now, think this problem in another way. This is 7, Samsung 7. And this is Android 7. Do you think it is a stock 7, it's the original version of 7? No. Samsung has engineered on that. Now that's the problem. Now if it is original this thing, operating system, you would have, backward compatibility, forward compatibility on the operating system level, they would have taken care. But now another issue is, manufacturer is going to engineer on that. This is another issue. Now, fourth one is network characteristics. Say that if I'm going to, deploy an app for US and India. I got network speed is totally different. Like, I don't know how many have tried to test on 2G network. We have the liberty of testing it on Wi-Fi. And we are happy with it. Correct? Now, this is the variability in the market. Now, come down to the test method. So here what I'm trying to convey is one test method which was introduced by these four researchers in IEEE Symposium on Service Oriented System Engineering. It was a conference paper. It's a 9-page paper. And what I'm trying to communicate here is the essence of it. Now it is logically divided into four: construction of a feature tree model, then you will go for clustering devices, ranking the cluster, and evaluating and analyzing the test coverage. So So you got four steps in that. Okay. So let's go into feature tree model. So this is these lines are leaf. This is a leaf node, this is a parent node. I'm gonna take Android. How many versions of Android are there? 5.1, 6.0, 7.0, 8.0. What does that mean? When I am gonna come out with this app is gonna work on these versions of Android. Okay? Now, screen size, 4.0, 5.0, 6.0. My app is compatible with these three. So these are all compatibility features. Correct? Now you might be thinking, my dual SIM is not there. My security is not there. My eye sensing is not there. If you think these are, okay, if you think that they are also important for you, please add. Now, but I'm going to shorten this to understand this test method better. Okay, now I got camera, I got 500, 600, 700. Resolution ratio is this 2 and size is 4.5 and 5.0. Okay, now how will I find the combinations of all this? How can I find the combinations of all this? Any ideas? I want to say that I want to test on 500, camera 500, resolution ratio is this, and I want to have a screen size of 4.5. I just want to know what are the combinations there. I'm not talking about the how to select the device or the simulators. I want to know what are the combinations which are available. Right? Now, for that, 500, 600, 700. I want you to focus on the screen, okay? 500, 600, 700. Okay, now, second one is 960, 540, 1280, 720. I got 960, 540, 1280, 720. Now, how will I? This is like you have like 11th standard, we have done a little bit of sets, correct? Now, let's try to do that. Let's try to 500. What is the next element? 960, 540. Right, now 600, 960, 540. Now 700, 960. 540. Now 500, this one. 500, 1280, 720. Correct? Now 600, 1280, 720. Now after that, what you will do? You will have 500, 960, this one, this combination, plus 4.5. Correct? Done? So how many combinations you got here? How many combinations you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That is the maximum number of combinations you got by having this feature tree model. Correct? Now, 500, this is, so if you recollect in this, A1 cross, A2 cross, A3, that is modulus of B, that is 12. So we are done with the first step. Now, okay. Now, Tony, can I have your mobile phone? Now, the thing is, now I am trying to find, I am going to take a phone on random from the list, and I am going to map this phone to any one of those combinations. Is it possible or not? So that is what I am trying to do. Now, for that, before doing that, let me ask you one simple question. This is the Shuni building. Now if I want to map this building to Kadakutam, Srigariam or Kovalam, which should be your first choice? 95% will say Kadakutam. Because shortest is the distance. Same logic we are going to use. Correct? Now, I want to know the distance between this phone to this. This phone to this. Now if this is shorter, it was mapped into this. That device had 2% of market share. The device is having 2% of market share. 10% is device A. Tony's device was having 10%, is having 10% of market share. Your device is having 2% of the entire market share. Right? I'm taking another device. Say that it is coming into this. So what is the total market share of this? 12%. Now if, so the logic is, if I test on Tony's device and my device, I will cover 12% of market share. Getting it? 88% and 1%. Pullback is 1%. So total market share is 17%. So by having these three devices, I will be covering 17% of the market. Now this is another interesting chart. This is, so I got weightage, cluster is there, weightage of the cluster. Now if I got, by Xiaomi, I will be There is no point about it. Most of the time what happens is that you want break or do you want to sit?
No, we'll have the break now and then.
Yeah. So we'll come and we'll after the break we'll go through the walkthrough. Okay.
So you have been to the previous sessions of FAYA for IT, and you might already know that during the results we connect the small skills on the basic technology stuff. You know, because this is a free knowledge sharing platform, we stay true to the purpose even during the so before I move on to the first question, let me just tell you that those who know the answer, please raise your hand. Otherwise there will be confusion and all of the subjects I'll get. So, the first question. Joseph Weizenbaum, an MIT professor, developed the first chatbot in the 1960s. What's the name of the chatbot? Those who know the answer, please raise your hand.
No,
not you. I didn't see many raised hands. Okay, I'll give you one clue. It is a female name.
Oh, one lady smiling over there. Yeah, any guess? What's the name of the first chatbot developed in the 1960s by an MIT professor, Joseph Weizenbaum? So all the gents out there, can you think of a lady name? So the answer is Eliza. All right. Moving on to the next question. What's the initiative by Google to support and women in the industry, that is in the industry of technology? This is an initiative by Google to support and empower women.
Women Entrepreneur Network. Women Entrepreneur Network created by?
No. The first word, women. It was launched in 2014. The two words, we'll keep the first word of what he said, women. Okay, you got an answer?
Question.
If you don't know the answer, then repeating the question won't help.
Okay.
Good idea.
Women tech makers.
Okay, so there is this organization or a community called the Google Women Tech Makers. So the first thing we'll think is that, okay, this is something only for women. No, it's not like that. This particular community is just to bring up or to encourage the women technology people who is out there. There are men who are part of this. There are women who are part of this. So basically they conduct sessions. If there is a group of people who want to learn a particular technology like Python or Android or something, a representative from the Google tech makers or the women tech makers, they can go out and help them. They can conduct sessions. They have meetups. They have regular meetups. So if you search the web, you will get the address of this particular community so that you can just join the gang. Yes. So, like for example, if we take this particular event, if we compare the ratio between men and women, obviously there are more men than women, right? So, wherever it is, we can see that there is a lesser number of women. Be technology, be it be any field, there is always, there could be many reasons for that, but once we give a little push, like once we encourage them or once they are given the right information or the right opportunity, they could come out in flying colors. So this particular initiative by Google is just to encourage all those women out there who need an encouragement or who need a push to come out in front of a group and just to come out in come in front of the society. That's it. So that's Google Women Tech Makers. So just join the community and encourage them. Yeah, thank you.
I deserve it, okay.
Yeah, sure. Okay, thanks, Arunima.
We should not encourage. The chocolate was coming to me and then we have people grabbing it.
Okay, thanks, Arunima. Again, have you had this discussion with your friends where you reveal the names your parents had originally planned to give you? For example, my name is Arya and my parents had originally planned to give me the name Archa. So some letters get deleted and some get added. So my question is, the name Google was created accidentally. And what's the original name the founders had for it? I hear some murmurings. Do you know the answer?
Backup.
The name Google, like they didn't need to name it Google. They had another name, but which was actually misspelled to Google.
Who gave the answer?
Right answer. I'm so glad. Who's on? Congrats. Now the final question. You see, the Avengers is trending in box office. So one of the main characters is Thor. So the question is, okay, there's a spoilers alert. Now, Thor creates a new weapon to shield the Avengers from the Thanos. Now the question is, what's the new weapon called? So you right answer again. All right. So, Stormbreaker is the answer. And I'll get one. Thank you. Anand, I think you can just continue the session.
Shall we? Okay. So we have to go walk through to the stop there. Okay. So this is a main page of AWS services, and Device Farm sits below that mobile services. Click on the Device Farm. Okay, here you will be presented with the projects. And projects means like it's a logical container to contain your runs, and runs is basically your test scripts and your device, chosen devices. Now, I click on a project. Now I told you I can create two kinds of test. One is an automated test, another is a remote test, remote access. Now if I click on that, remote access is basically it's used for, like, if you find one specific problem that this app is failing, or this IPA is failing on specific device, then I click on the remote access, then I can just push this IPA into that specific device and test on it. Okay, so rather than testing it on a simulator or emulator, you will be presented with a real device. Now if I click on the automated test, you will be presented with create new run button. Like automated test, as I have said, it is like you got a test, you got an application, you got a test, push it to the AWS, and AWS runs it and gives you a log, screenshots and videos. Okay. Now I click on create new run. Now this is choose application, this is your IPA, iOS or Android, or you can also test your web apps. Right, now I click on the native apps, I click here. Now it prompts you to upload your IPA, APK, either IPA or APK. Now for this demo, I'm going to use an IPA. I'm going to click here. So I choose a IPA, open. So while it is uploading, it evaluates your metadata of your IPA, and that is presented. It will be there in your test script. It processes your IPA. Now you'll be presented with the details, metadata of that. Now next step is, I click on next step, then I will have the test frameworks available for IPA. I'll have the built-in first test is there, and I got versions of APM test, Calabash, UI automation, and XE test UI. Now the difference between a built-in first test and all others are, say that if you do not have a script, and a script is not made, or if your organization is not mature enough, or don't have time to invest on a script, what you can do is you can select first. In first, AWS Device Farm streams in user interface inputs. Say that, like tap, swipe, I mean navigation, user input events into your application. You got two options for that, event count. So 700 numbers or event counts are pushed into your app. And you got another settings called a randomizer seed. Randomizer seed is, I'll put this way, if in test one, if my randomizer seed is 5, and if in my test 2 the randomizer seed is also 5, then AWS Device Farm will be using the same user inputs. Like in test 1 it will be touch, test 2 also be touch, correct? So it will be same sequence of events will be pushed into your application, right? So if you want to repeat your test, this maintaining a same randomizer seed will help you. So I click on 5. Now next step is, I have to select the devices. Here this thing, AWS Device Farm gives you a top 5 devices, a selection of top 5 devices. It is from their market research and customer interaction, they give you a top 5 devices. You can choose that and go to next step, or if you want to edit, you want to create your own pool, right? Say you can create new pool, click on that. You can enter my grade pool name, select your devices and click on next. You can always you have a set of devices, you can select it from there and you can save my device pool. Another option is I can use the same pool which I created earlier. You don't have to create a pool every time, right? You can do that. I can drop down the pool and say migrate pool, right? I selected one device for that and I can go for the next step. Here I will be presented with more configurations. I can have extra data which has to be there in the phone when the application is tested, like an image file, like some other files, like whatever may be, you can upload it there. You can also upload other apps. Say that you are going to test your app in conjunction with a social media app. So you want to install that and you can switch the app and look into it. Whether it is switching properly, you are sending the data properly, you can test that. Another use case could be like if you are going to test an upgrade. So you are going to install your lower version of your app first, then lower version of your app will be installed first. Then when you go for a test, your higher version will kick it. You have an option for device location and you can create your own network. You can choose your own network, right? Now I click on next step. Now this is a timeout. I'll set it for 5. Timeout is something like this. I got an application which was tested locally in my I have test scripts in my environment. I have tested it and it is going to take only 3 minutes or 5 minutes. Now if I upload this application and I'm going to test this application on a APK or IPA on the AWS device farm on an unknown device, what might happen? Test might be successful, test might fail, or it freezes. In that case, the timeout kicks in. That will save your per minute cost. Okay, so confirm and start run. So it will acquire the device and starts the run. Now during that run I will show you the result of another run which we did on a Android application. This run was conducted on 5 different devices on the same time. My device pool was 5 and it was an Android application. Now if I take an Android application, I got an option of fuzz and explorer. Now you saw fuzz explorer is not for Android. Now the difference between a fuzz and explorer is fuzz sends a stream of user input user interface events onto your application. But in case of a explorer, it crawls through the application tries to analyze the screen, it clicks on the, clicks on the first link, goes and scrolls it, crawl it, try to analyze the screen and move ahead. But this functionality is only there in Android device. So this test was conducted like that. So rather than focusing on what is the error, we'll try to understand how the error is displayed. Now, you see the unique problems. You see the list one unique problem and another unique problem. So during the test, I had a problem. Say that I am not able to click a link. This happened in two devices. This happened in two devices. So how many times this problem is going to occurred will be on that other side. Right, in how many devices? Like say that built-in Explorer test failed. It is written two. So it means that in two devices we had that problem. This test failed in one device. Are you able to get it? Now, there are screenshots available for the test. If you have scripted in such a way that you want the screenshot, it will be available there. Now what? Now I click on, if I want to know the details of that of this problem, I can click here. Let me click it. So it will be, you have the video of that test along with the logs of the test with your performance of your app. You have your CPU performance, memory performance, etc. You can click on the video and see what has happened. So to that granular level, they will give you the result. Right? Now, you have seen first, you have seen Explorer. We'll also take one more kind of a test called APM Java TestNG, which is available for both Android as well as iOS. Now essentially APM Java TestNG is a Node.js server and it is an automation framework. It uses the native Android or iOS automation functionalities. So in that case, you do not have to instrument your code. Third thing is, it is cross-platform. The script written for Android will also work for iOS. So it's a very popular test framework and AWS Device Farm supports it. On the client side, you'll be using APM client functionalities to send requests to your mobile phone, and you'll be asserting that using a TestNG framework, right? AWS expects your test and dependencies. When you're testing for, when you're using APM Java TestNG framework, your test and your dependencies should be zipped and pushed to AWS Device Farm. AWS expects you to do that. Secondly, it supports 6.5, 7.1, and 7.2, and it expects you to create your project using Maven. Now, I got a small test script. So this is a files and folders or file structure of that test script. Now, rather than going into the semantics and syntax of writing a Java code, I'll tell you what are the things which is required for you, to extra things which is required by the AWS Device Farm. Okay. Now the first thing is dependencies. So your pom.xml will have the entries which tells you the dependencies which will help you in zipping your test files. Second thing, your ATest annotation will be in your test script. Other annotations will be in your test base. So this will be a top level class to this. Third thing is decide capabilities. If you have familiarity in APM Java Test NG framework, first thing you will be telling us decide capabilities. Like you will be mentioning your Android version, platform version and your device name. You are supposed to comment that three in you are supposed to comment that three details. I'll show you that in the test script. Fourth thing is you are supposed to test your APM Java Test NG in a pre-launch mode. Okay. This is the screen. This is my home page and I got a confirmation page. So the first point was pom.xml. Let me show you pom.xml. I'll have the dependencies, entries of the dependencies here, and I'll have the plugins which will help me in zipping my test here. Second thing we said, you will have head test annotations in the test script. This is my test script and these are my two tests. So before I explain what are my tests, let me show my home page first. This is as per the APM standards, you are supposed to do that in a page object model in which you will have the locators and functionalities for a specific page in one file. That is like the function, the locators and the functionality specific to this screen will be in one file. These locators are here and the functionalities are here. This functionality is basically filling up the name. So in POM model, page object model, you will be having the locators and the functionalities of a single page in one file. Now what is my test here? Test is very simple. I enter the name, I click on register, it will show that gender name is not specified, it validates that whether that message is coming. Now second test is I will clear this and I click on register. What should happen? It should say that full name is not present. So I will validate two messages. One message will be like enter your full name, enter your name. Second one is enter your gender. So these are the two validations I got. So I got that in a static string and my test is I'm going to reset all reset all fields. I'm going to click on the register button and I'm going to validate whether I'm getting that message. Okay. Now the fourth thing, okay, third thing which we said was decide capabilities. So this is my file which this is my this thing, top level class of the test test, and I got three entries for platform version and device name. This is compulsory when you are running the script on a local system. But think about using these entries when you are running the script from AWS Device Farm. You do not know the devices, you do not know the platform, correct? So if you do not comment it, you are going to get an unexpected result, right? So you are supposed to comment it. Now the fourth thing was running this test in a pre-launch mode. So let me show you that. So I'm going to run it. So before I run it, so I'm going to test this script locally here. So before I test it, I want to make sure my device is connected to my laptop. So for that, what I have to do is edb devices. It shows me the devices connected. Now second thing is I want to run the APM in pre-launch mode. This is how you run the APM in pre-launch mode. It is pre-launch here. So what is it? What are you aware of what is pre-launch? Pre-launch is when you run your APM script, you can start your application from the script or before that. From when you're executing your script, you can start it. That is normal mode. Pre-launch mode is doing this. So before running your script, you have already started your application. Now my APM server is up, my device is connected. Now what next? I'm going to run as testng. So I'll have my in the screen you will have the Node.js, I mean APM logs, and in the device you will have the correct. This is how you test your scripts locally. Okay, done. Done. So my script is ready. Okay, now what should I do? I have to push it to the AWS Device Farm. What package should I do? It should be in SIPT. Now I should use this command. This command to zip it. Maybe. AWS Device Farm expects you to create the project in Maven. So this zip file will be located in at this folder, target folder. Now you are ready to copy that. So when you choose, like you will be opening up the AWS Device Farm, you will be clicking on that project, uploading your application APK. Then in your next screen you will be choosing APM Java testng. When you click that, you will be asked to upload your zip file. So you upload it. The next step is to use your pool, create your pool or edit the pool, whatever it is. Then you can run your test. Done. You can have that same script. You can have the script and you will have your URL in the script. Same thing. You can have APM script and it opens up a URL in your device. No, Selenium framework, AWS Device Farm does not support Selenium. It should be in APM, Calabash or whatever it is. Done. Now so we come to the last point. that is continuous integration and testing. Now, if you talk about Agile, it's about sprints. Now, you have a small piece of code, you try to put this into your application. That is, you are integrating integrating continuously. Your application is growing and you want to test. You are not waiting for a big integration to come in. Okay, that will reduce a lot of your work. So every small thing you're going to integrate it and you're going to test that in the AWS device form. Now what if, like, we have identified three things here. Okay, one is I have a test. Second thing, I want to test that in AWS device form. And third thing is, if the test was successful, I want to release that into my hockey app or whatever may be. Hockey app is a place where it is like you can tell your testers, please download from there. It's ready for deployment. Or you can pass it over to your production. Now, Jenkins will allow you to download your test and APK from Git. It has got a Git plugin. Jenkins has got a Git plugin by which you can download your APK and application from a Git. Jenkins can use your Maven installation to pack that into a zip file. Jenkins have got plugins to communicate with your device form. It uploads your package into device form and test happens there, and Jenkins will show you the results. If the test is good, Jenkins has got plugins to contact, and if you have installed the plugins, you can upload your app into Hockey. Done. So I'll show you that. First thing is, I'll have to show you how to install a plugin. So this is the Jenkins homepage. Now, to install a plugin, I have to go to Manage Jenkins. I can go for Manage Plugins. So in my case, these plugins are already installed. So it will be, otherwise you have to click on the Available and search for the plugins. So you have to search for the plugin. Otherwise, in my case, it is already installed. So I click on install and this is AWS plugin. Right. So you can install Git, AWS and Hockey plugin. And after that, what happens? You can click on a new item in which you can start configuring all the things, all the three steps, all the other steps into one item. Let me show you that. I got a registration item in which I have already configured to get my test scripts and my APK from Git. This is a place where I have stored my test scripts and my APK. Now, after that, I am using a Maven to zip it. Right? Now, after that, I am opening up, contacting AWS device form, and this is my project. This is my pool, and I am going to upload my application into that. After that, I'm going to choose my test. This is APM Java Test NG test, and I'm going to use this .zip file. After that, I contact Hockey app using the credentials, and I'm giving settings for this app. So if that app is available in the Hockey, so it is going to send, you can send the mails out to your test team. So in one item, you can do everything. So you can also keep this in the small modules. That is what you call that as pipeline. So this is how a pipeline looks. So in this, you're going to contact a Git server, Git repository, and you will be downloading your APK and this thing. Second step is contact the device farm. Third thing is, okay. So the good thing about this is it's in very, very small modules. So if I have some changes, I can incorporate it. So if tomorrow I don't want Hockey app, I can, if I want a Google Play Store, I can just add this here. So if it is a very, long pipeline, you can cut into small pieces. Long process, you can cut into small pieces. Correct? So how do you run it? By just one click of a button, everything is there. Right, so when you are, you can configure Jenkins such a way that if your developers have checked in some code, you can say the Jenkins to kick in. It will automatically, you can also have steps to make an APK file using a Gradle, and you have an APK file, then you have test files in your Git, you can download that. Correct? Now you move to the AWS device farm. So it all happens without anybody's interference, automatic, right? So it will happen for every, you can have a twice a day build. So it is not a, you can use this with AWS device farm, right? So with that, I think you have filled in most of the things. So that is your summary. So in which we talked about the variability in the market. We did a case study. We did a test method, understood a test method. You saw the experiment and the statistical tabular column and the experience tabular column, and then after that you understood how to list devices. Then we moved to device farm, in which we did Explorer as well as Fuzz. We took an example of APM Test NG. Then we moved into Jenkins, pipeline, introduction to CI/CD, and a sample project. Any questions? Okay. Okay. Now, to start with, you don't do that. You have 1,000 minutes of sampled in this thing. Demo time. After that, you can go for unmetered or metered. Metered means you have 17 cents for a minute. Whatever the device, whatever the test, whatever happens, 17 cents per device, per 17 cents per time. That is a metered charge. Non-metered is $250 for a slot. In one slot, you can put any device. So if you have, say that if you have five slots, you can ask for five slots. So $250 into five for a month. So, but I am not, like there are a lot of device farms out there. There are a lot of device farms out there. So you can also go and check the cost and service of the others. Okay. So you got a lot of options there. Any other questions? Yeah. Now I'll tell you this. I'll tell you. If you are coding with conjunction with your developer, you tell them to put an ID. And if you have the same ID for iOS and APM, iOS and Android, you can maintain one single code. Yeah, yeah, okay. Now, for Angular, do not use Selenium. Use Protractor.
Yeah, we are actually
Protractor. So, you have to find another ecosystem to use Protractor. Any other questions? Oh, no. There is another framework. Sir, you got a question? No, it is possible. It's possible. Like, I think it is an IDE, correct? You can have, I'm using an IDE for creating your. No, I'm using an IDE for creating my scripts, right? And AWS Device Farm expects your thing to be in zip format. Any other questions? It should be created in the Maven. AWS expects the test scripts to be in Maven. IP. So if you want to have a cross platform, truly if you want to have a cross platform, make sure that you are using the same IDs. Otherwise, like if I got an ID dot is name 001 and I'm using name 0, another kind of this thing, nomenclature in iOS, and you will not have the cross platform. You cannot take the advantage of a cross platform. Yeah, I think. Yeah, it's possible. Should be there. I'm not sure, but the browser, I'm sure. Any other questions?
So I guess this marks the end of the 16th edition of Firepod Haiti. Thank you so much for the insightful session. We really appreciate you putting the time and effort to make the event a success.
It's been a pleasing pleasure to talk to you.
Next, I invite Mr. Vibhus Nath, Managing Director of FAYA, to present him with a memento and also to address the audience thereafter.
So, how was the session? I didn't see much interactions today. So what happened? So first of all, it is just like giving us a glimpse on how actually we should see testing mobile applications, okay. And we just need to see like that is where we are standing right now and where the industry is. And these terms that you hear, that is you are, even if you are listening to the first time, it doesn't matter. And do not think like these things are very much complex that you cannot do that. These things are just unfamiliar to you. So this is just like introducing those terms to you, and it is your effort. It is, if you really want to work in that standard, just go back, research, and start working on it. And it is not like it is unaccomplishable by anyone. It is just like we are not used to it or we are not familiar to it. It is not complex. So I think like that is initially that is when he talking to me about the session, I was asking like how much time we will be talking about this formula and calculations. Then he told like it is just like around 40 minutes. I think like initially that is how did it go? That calculation, did everyone get that? Yeah, so normally we always think about that is testing in 5 different devices and we talk in terms of those devices. Right now it is just like an eye opener. Like it is not like thinking about devices, it should be specification and we should be more, that is we should be looking more into that. And I tell like that is I have tested in these specification and we have this level of test coverage. So that was just like an eye opener for me also. And about AWS Device Farm, just need to know like there are device farms that are available and there are different device farms that you have to go back and check. And if you are new to Jenkins also, that's fine, just go back and research on it. And these things, these new things make your life much better. Like initially it will take some time for you to configure, get things running, but after that, that is, once you get acquainted with that, that is, you will feel like that is how you couldn't live without those technologies. So that is what, that is whenever something new comes in, it is not coming to make our life harder. It is just like help us improve our performance, improve the productivity, and improve the quality, because it will make us consistently delivering with quality. So thank you, Anand. And Arun ji is the committee this month. Okay. And this marks the end of 5 years of FAYA Portity. And thanks a lot for coming here. And actually, that is, how many of you are new to FAYA Portity, coming here for the first time? Okay. So this FAYA Portity happens on first Wednesdays every month. And this is the 60th edition, so we are completing 5 years. And first Wednesday it happens in Trivandrum, second Wednesday in Kochi, and third Wednesday in Kozhikode. And we have a Facebook group as well as a Facebook page called FAYA Portity. So it stands for free knowledge sharing. Because normally that is everywhere, that is we want to go and pay to get access to technology sessions. And mostly people, that is trainers, come and take sessions. So we actually want people from the community who actually do the coding, who does hands-on, who has hands-on experience, come and take sessions. So even if anyone, it is just like finding speakers from our community itself, and we are happy like that we have over 60 speakers so far. So if anyone is also interested to take sessions, please do contact Arunima. So she will be coordinating the future of FAYA Portity sessions. Okay. Thank you. Yes, yes. So this event was live streamed. So you can go and search for FAYA Portity and you will see our YouTube channel. You can see all our previous session. Even for Jenkins, there was a full session of Jenkins previously. Okay. So, and also that is, you will be receiving a feedback email in which we will send you the link to access the photos, access the slide, and identify, find our Facebook and Twitter pages. Okay.
And also make sure that you get your details as conference paper.
Yeah.
This thing is available. Make sure that you get it. So I'll pass it over to people tomorrow.
And please do give your feedback. Do not just like click the link and discard it. Please do give feedback. And FAYA is also to find new people and make new friends. That is, people from different companies are here who are of similar interest. If you want to network, that is, we are, it is also open for that. And if any other thing, that is, for example, if you are facing some real challenges in your work, that is, you can, it is just like you can openly talk, because that is, people from different experience levels are here. They might be able to help.
So even if you have any questions, you can ask. That's all. Thank you.